Today we're gonna be talking about 10 new prestigious ranks for the bounty hunter role. I will give you some tips, tricks and my overall impressions about this bounty hunter role extension. First of all, how to buy it? Well, it's pretty easy. If you are a bounty hunter, go to any bounty hunter board and instead of $3 bounty hunter poster, there will be elite bounty hunter license advertisement. I guess I said bounty hunter too many times during the last 20 seconds, but after all it's a bounty hunter guide. Anyway, you can pay 15 gold bars and become elite bounty hunter. No cutscenes this time, but you will get an access for new legendary bounties, new $3 bounty missions, infamous bounties, which are like 3 missions connected together, and of course 10 more levels in a bounty hunter role to unlock with new cosmetics and not only cosmetics. First of all, let's talk about legendary bounties. There are only 3 new legendary bounties in the game file, so I assume that's all we're gonna get. Anyway, you can see the posters and I call them Brad Pitt, Jennifer Lopez and Benny Hill. By the way, thanks to Randy for sharing these images with me. Anyways, this week we can only catch Brad Pitt and I've already completed it on 5 stars difficulty and it's pretty easy comparing to other legendary bounties in the game. I believe it's because it was designed as a solo mission. Anyway, I've spent less than 10 minutes to catch him and get him to the bounty board and then I've waited for 20 more minutes to see the reward, and reward is pretty standard. 0.48 gold bars, $187 and 3000 experience points, but remember, this week we have double experience points on all the bounty hunter missions, so it's regular 1500 experience points for legendary bounty. In my opinion, there is nothing special about this legendary bounty, but let's wait for another 2 legendaries. Maybe there will be something interesting. But what I really enjoyed in this bounty hunter upgrade and what makes it worth 15 gold bars in my opinion are the new infamous bounty targets. You can find them at any bounty hunter board, just go to the $3 bounties and switch the poster. It's a 3 bounty hunter missions connected together and unique for every bounty hunter message board. So since we have 13 boards, it's a total of 39 new missions. Once you're gonna complete one mission, it will cross the target on the poster and you will be able to make the next one. But remember, there is a cooldown between missions. It's about 1 hour, definitely more than for legendary bounties. After completing the last 3rd mission, you will get extra $75. And it doesn't matter how much time you will spend on this mission. You're definitely getting the regular amount of gold, no bonuses here, and about experience I'm not quite sure. Because of all these bonuses and multipliers for the bounty hunter rewards, it bugs sometimes and doesn't work correctly. For example, I've got almost 2000 experience for completing last infamous bounty from Emerald Station and spending 20 minutes, and I've got like 200 experience points for completing last infamous bounty in Blackwater and spending 5 minutes on that. So anyway, if there is a bonus experience, it definitely not a constant, unlike with the dollars. Of course, all the infamous bounty missions are replayable. So here is my first tip. If you want to grind these infamous missions, you have to pick 4 or 5 different bounty boards and after completing it in one place, go to the other. That's how, while infamous bounty is on the cooldown in the first town, you will be able to make it in other towns and then move back when cooldown is over. So now my impressions. I enjoyed this infamous bounty is not only because there are some cutscenes and some missions I actually feel like a story, not all of them but some. I enjoyed these new missions because gameplay is actually fun. Unlike with the regular bounty hunter missions, these ones are actually fun to play. It seems like Rockstar have learned the lesson and bounty hunter missions are not boring anymore. And it's kinda funny because mostly they are consist of the regular bounty hunter mission mechanics, but they combined in a such way that it's kinda fun to play. And yes, the fact that you have to complete all 3 missions to get additional reward actually helps. I don't know why, but it does. It's more interesting this way. Also, it seems like a reasonable way to grind money and gold in Red Dead Online. At the moment, I'm working on my video about the new best methods of grinding and I have to make more calculations and experiments, but so far it seems like an okay method at least. Anyway, let me know in the comments what do you think about this infamous bounty target. targets, but for me it was probably the most enjoyable part of this update. And now let's talk about the new 10 levels for the Bounty Hunter. As always, there are some rewards on each level. The most interesting for me are provision satchel upgrade, because it's always useful to carry more provision with you, new gun tricks, shoulder toss and figure 8 toss, because without gun tricks, how will you flex in the Wild West? By the way, how do you use these new gun tricks? Just open the left menu, go to the online options and check this gun spinning category, and there will be all the tricks available. You can preview them and decide whether you like them, and if you want to, you can equip them, because there are only 4 gun tricks can be equipped at the same time. And yeah, to perform the trick, you have to hold the gun in your hand, double tap the button, which is different for each platform, you can see them on your screen, and then hold the next button and choose the trick that you want to perform. Anyway, other rewards. New ballers. You can buy 9 more ballers, and they are extremely expensive. I will test them completely and will make more detailed video or whether it's worth to buy them at all. Also, we have some different bounty wagon cosmetics. Again, super expensive one. New saddle. I already have the review on this on my channel, link will be in the description, but it's okay. And of course, we have a lot of cosmetics. The most interesting is the LeMar revolver variants. 21 gold bars each, and you have to buy 2 of them if you're using 2 LeMar revolvers, so it's gonna cost you 42 gold bars to have LeMars like that. And it's just wow. I mean, how much is that? $15 in real money, or grinding daily challenges forever after the nerf? Anyway, overall I'm not really impressed with the cosmetics this time, but there are some good looking items. What is more important, after reaching level 30 in the Bounty Hunter role, you will be able to trade some experience to money and gold. How to do this? Go to menu, open progress, choose awards and go to the Bounty Hunter page. The last award will be called Bounty Hunter. As you can see, you have to earn 10,000 experience to get $100 and half of the gold bar. And it's nothing in my opinion. I mean, even with the bonus experience this week, it's not worth it. Yeah, like other awards, this one can be reset unlimited amount of times, but reward is just too small. From my calculation, it should be at least 2 gold bars. Basically, it changes nothing when we're talking about earnings per hour. To be honest, I'm really disappointed with this one. I mean, they could have made a cool mechanic, but greed prevents them from being cool. Okay, now let's talk about some other changes in the Bounty Hunter role that worth to mention. First of all, they've changed a little bit free roam bounty missions payouts. Now you will get a little bit more if you will complete the mission in between 5 and 10 minutes. I'm not quite sure whether it really gonna affect the most effective ways of grinding, I have to check it. Also, player bounty missions will happen more often in the free roam, even with the small bounties, but to me it looks kinda weird. It seems like a cheap attempt to force players to do PvP in the free roam, but with these pathetic rewards it's not kinda worth it, you will spend more on tonics. But new free roam bounty hunter encounters are even more stupid. I was super glad to spot one of them, because they are pretty rare, but when I've delivered the target, I've got only $1.125 experience points and no gold at all. I mean, yeah, it was less than 4 minutes, but I still have to earn more than $1 for that.
That's what she said!
Also, there are some new daily challenges for bounty hunters, at least I don't remember them. For example, take pictures of the bounty target, and few others that I've never seen. But anyways, that's it. So overall, I enjoyed this Bounty Hunter role upgrade. Cosmetics is okay, legendary bounty is fine, infamous bounties are pretty cool in my opinion. But there is one problem, that's all that we've got for 4 months of waiting, and even more, it doesn't seem like we're gonna get any other new content pretty much anytime soon. But anyway, let me know in the comments what do you think about the Bounty Hunter role upgrade, and as always, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. До свидания.